Good morning, my dear students. Once again, welcome to online classes of mathematics. Today we shall start a new chapter, that is triangle for class 9. So you have already know about what is triangle. Triangle is a closed figure formed by three intersecting lines. So triangle is a closed figure formed by three intersecting lines. So this is a triangle. Triangle is a closed figure formed by three intersecting lines. Next, triangle consists of three sides, that is side AB and side AC and side BC. Next, it consists of three angles, angle 1, angle 2 and angle 3, and it consists of three vertices, that is vertex M, vertex N, vertex O. It consists of three vertices. Next, move on to the congruency. Did you know about what is congruency? Congruency means it is a closed figure having same size and shape. Both are same. So here is a two chalk piece. It is having same height and it is also having same shape. So we can say that these two chalk pieces are congruent to one another. I think you are understanding the concept of congruency. It consists of an object consists of same size and same shape, then we can say that these two chalk pieces are congruent to one another. Next, take another example, that is it is a circle. These are two circles. These are two circles having, it is a closed figure. It consists of same shape. These two shapes are equal. Next, it is also having same size. Then we can say that these two circles are congruent to one another. So, next take another example. congruence rule, or it is called as AAS theorem. Angle side, angle congruence rule, or angle side, angle theorem. The statement of the theorem is two triangles are congruent if two angles are included side of one triangle are equal to two angles and included side of another triangle, then these two triangles are congruent to one another. If two triangles are congruent if two angles included side of another triangle are equal to one another, then we can say that these two triangles are congruent to one another. So let's prove the theorem. So here are two triangles, angle A, angle B. Triangle ABC and triangle PQ are two triangles. So they have given angle B is equal to angle Q, angle C is equal to angle R, and BC, these two side is equal to this side is equal to this side. They have given in the statement. We have to prove these two triangles are congruent to one another. For case 1, you have to consider AB is equal to, and side AB is equal to side PQ. You have to consider these two sides are equal to one another. Next, BC is equal to QR. This is given. These two sides are equal. They have given already in the question. Therefore, angle B is equal to angle C. This is also given. Now, from the side angle side, if this side is equal to this side, and this angle is equal to this angle, and this side is equal to this side, on the basis of side angle side congruence rule, these two triangles are equal to one another. Triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR. On the basis of side angle side congruence rule, side angle side congruence rule, these two triangles are congruent to one another. Let's take another case, that is case 2. Consider two triangles and consider point D on the triangle ABC and join this point. So AB is equal to PQ. You have to consider this. This side is equal. You have to consider. Next, AB is less than PQ. Next, BD is equal to BD. This side BD is equal to PQ. You have to consider. Next, angle B is equal to angle C. This is given. Next, angle BC, side BC is equal to side QR. BC is equal to QR. This is given. So from the side angle side, this side is equal to this side, and this angle is equal to this angle, and this side is equal to this side. So according to side angle side congruence rule, these two triangles are congruent to one another. Triangle DBC is congruent to triangle PQR on the basis of side angle side rule. Next, angle ECB is equal to angle PRQ. Angle ACB is equal to angle PRQ. This angle BC is equal to this side. BC is equal to QR. BC is equal to QR. We have to. This is also D1. Sorry, BD is equal to PQ. You have to consider this side is equal. Next, so from the congruency rule, BBC triangle BBC is congruent to triangle PRQ on the basis of SAS rule. On the basis of SAS rule, triangle DBC is congruent to triangle PRQ on the basis of side angle side rule. This side is equal to this side, this angle is equal to this angle, and this side is equal to this side. On the basis of side angle side, these two triangles are congruent to one another. Next, BCD is equal to PRQ on the basis of CP, CD. Therefore, AD is equal to PQ. On the basis of CP, CD, DCB, this angle is equal to this angle. On the basis of corresponding pair of congruent.